What's up, Saturn fans? A while ago, I made a video about Virtua Cop 3, the arcade-exclusive sequel to the classic Sega franchise, which you can now play on the CXVX emulator. The problem, as many of you pointed out, is that at the time, the emulator only supported a gamepad, which is really not the ideal way to play a light gun shooter. Well, now you can. The emulator is constantly being worked on and updated, and on the latest version you can finally play with your mouse. So here's how you can set that up. I am not going to cover the whole process of configuring the emulator from scratch. If you need help with that, please do watch my previous video. On this one, I'll really just focus on the mouse aim thing. So start by opening up the emulator and go to settings and config input. Now you can already see that there are some mouse options showing. I have tried messing with these values, but in my experience, the default settings worked the best. So if you're not comfortable with your setup, you might want to mess with this, but for most people, I think the default settings are going to be best. Now, up here you have MS gamepad, which the thing with this emulator and how it now supports mouse aim is it doesn't actually support direct mouse input. What it does is it emulates the gamepad, but you're using your mouse instead of the analog stick. So select gamepad and configure. Now, instead of gamepad, you want to select keyboard and mouse. And now we have to set up the keys that we want to use. We don't need to set up every button you see here, just the ones that we actually need to play the game. So on for the A button, I'm going to use my left mouse click, and for the B button, I'm going to use the right mouse click. Every other button I'm going to leave as it is. What we now have to configure is the left stick, which is the stick that you use to control your aim. And this is where you have to set up your mouse so that the game uses your mouse input instead of an actual analog stick. So you should start by clicking each direction and moving your mouse in that direction. And you're going to see that it says axis. Now we don't actually want axis, because if you leave it like this, what's going to happen is that once you stop moving your mouse, your aim is going to reset back to the center of the screen, which is terrible. So what you want to do is you maintain your shift key pressed, and now you click with your right mouse button, and instead of axis, it turns into cursor. And you do this for every direction. And that's it, now you can save a profile, so it keeps these settings, and you just get out of this window and start the game as usual. As you can see, the emulation isn't exactly perfect. You can see that the fact that it's not the raw mouse input, that it's emulating the analog stick, doesn't translate perfectly on screen. So that's something that could still be improved, but it's still much better than playing it with a gamepad, like so much better. Lacking an actual light gun, this is the best way by far to actually experience the game. And by the way, for a long time, the increased resolution wasn't working properly. Even if you set it up in the options, the game would still render at a native resolution, which is really low by today's standards. So fortunately, that has been fixed as well. As you can see, I'm running at a full HD resolution and it looks pretty neat. So yeah, that's it. Go play Virtua Cop 3 with your mouse. And have fun. This is Nuno for the Saturn Junkyard. See ya.